Red Creek Valley seemed like a quiet, ordinary place. I've learned two things in my life. No place is truly quiet, and nowhere is really ordinary. Ethan warned me about that. Warned me not to be fooled by what I saw here. He didn't need to worry. I'd worked dozens of cases, hundreds. This would be my last one. Already I knew that.
Thank you.
trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow. I've seen every version of people hurting each other, hurting themselves. And we blame it on compulsion, selfishness, madness. I suppose the idea is, if you name the thing, you can control it. There are things in this world that cannot be named.
Why are you standing there? You spying?
No.
No, huh? What the hell's wrong with you exactly?
Nothing.
You need to stop leaving your stupid stories around. They're freaking everyone out.
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing! I found a room.
Pop, they're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not.
It's not my fault. I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandergriff house again. Said he found some secret room.
Yeah, really? Okay, I will go talk to him.
here for many reasons. They want to ask me questions about the future. And I can see the future. So it is the past that interests me. If you want to find my house, you must answer the questions I ask of you. Do you feel there is vanity, charity? Is cheating truly unfair to others? Does death bring peace or suffering? Would you prefer anonymity over notoriety?
Ethan, the point of life is not to rock the boat. Just try to get along. Stop living in your head. Do something real. That's what people respond to. Reality.